The QMJHL is proud to present this 2021 NHL Draft Prospect Watch. Here's Val-d'Or center Justin Robida. He's the son of former NHL defenseman Stefan Robida and was born in Texas while his father was playing for the Dallas Stars. At 5'7", he is a smaller size center, but hey, height is just a number, and Justin Robida plays a lot bigger than his size. His compete level is extremely high, and he'll often initiate contact with players who are 6 or 7 inches taller than him, and more often than not, he wins those battles. Now, while protecting the puck, he uses his smarts to find open space, and as we've seen in recent years, that is often the case with smaller players who reach the NHL, guys like Brayden Point and Johnny Gaudreau, for example. Now, whether it's forechecking or backchecking, Robida never quits on a play, and we've seen many examples of that during his junior career so far. He leaves it all on the ice. Robida is a good skater. After picking up the puck, he'll quickly launch a transition play for his team. This sequence illustrates that well. First, Robida places himself in a great position. He separates the player from the puck using his body, and Robida sees that he has a lot of space in front of him. He uses his speed, passes through 2 forwards in the neutral zone, and gets his team into the attacking zone. His attention to the little details is impressive on this play. Robida plays a high-speed, high-energy type of game, a quality that translates well to today's up-tempo NHL. His number one quality is undoubtedly his hockey sense. He has one of the best hockey IQs of his entire draft class, and it's likely influenced by his dad. Now, he plays sound positional hockey, and he always seems to be near the action. While defending, a center has to support his defenseman, and he does it beautifully. He does a good job of shutting down center ice for his opponents, applying pressure, and picking up pucks. If he has to block an opponent's route, he will. If he has to cut down passing lanes, well, he'll do that too. Even against older, bigger, and more skilled players, Robida holds his own defensively. Now look at this sequence against Dawson Mercer. Robida is patient in the neutral zone as he's analyzing the play. Mercer creates an odd man rush, but thanks to his great positioning, Robida easily cuts down the pass. And Mercer picks up the puck behind the net, but it's away from his body. Robida recognizes this. He pivots his hips to neutralize the stick, and Mercer loses the puck. Some impressive stuff here against a player from Canada's World Junior team, and winning battles like this against better players could bode well when it comes to transitioning to the next level. While his defensive play is very good, Robida is also very impressive on offense. When he's not carrying the puck, he often tries to disappear from coverage, which has resulted in him scoring a few goals over the last couple of years, mainly from the left side of the net. Robida has a good shot. It's not necessarily hard, but it is precise. He relied on it to score several of his 19 goals last year. He can shoot on the move, and he can also do it with speed, which of course can be very challenging for the opposition netminder. Now, Robida handles himself fairly well in the faceoff circle. Last season, for example, he won 56% of his draws, not bad for a 17-year-old, and you know, some of those faceoff wins led to goals. NHL Central Scouting ranks Justin Robida 47th among skaters in North America. That's good for 7th among QMJHL draft prospects. He was dealing with an injury during Val-d'Or's President Cup final against Victoriaville. We'll see if that influences any teams come draft time.